Good evening and welcome to Sensual Talk. This is the place where we talk all things sensual, tantalizing, and delicious. Holidays are just around the corner, and I want to invite you all to a little cocktail party. And I have a very special guest who's bringing champagne. There we go. This is not only a very, I wouldn't even say a special person. She is like my family. This is, ladies and gentlemen, my best friend, Anna G. We got some people coming over as well. So tonight we got a lot in store for you. I want to thank you all for joining us tonight for our, you know, little sensual cocktail party. If you did not RSVP, that's really quite all right. You're still invited to join us. I hope that you can stick with us for the next 15 minutes or so, because we got a lot of things planned, a lot of things coming your way. I want to use this opportunity to give a shout out to Dronish Media, who is sponsoring us tonight, just like other nights when we're hosting Sensual Talk. So thank you very much for making this happen. And you know what? So many things to talk about, so many things to celebrate. Whatever it is that you're celebrating on your end, you certainly can celebrate with us, because we want to invite and include everyone. So happy holidays.
Anna, happy holidays.
Thank you so much for being a part of Sensual Talk.
My pleasure. I'm so excited to be here.
And, you know, I have to tell you a couple of things about Anna. You know, Anna has always been there for me. If there is a person who I can talk about, you know, I can say, you know, through thick and through thin, this girl has been there for me through thick and through thin, through relationships, through you know, ups and downs, through different jobs, and she's always been there for me. So you know what, I want to dedicate this episode to you and our friendship, and I want to celebrate it.
Thank you. Likewise, Emanuela, you've been so amazing through thick and thin. She listens to my problems, even if it's a 2-hour problem.
So boring.
And no matter what I do, is like, if she asks me what I do and I say, oh, I just slept for 24 hours, she says, good for you. Good for you, you're such a hero.
Listen,
so supportive. No one is as supportive as Emanuela is, so I'm very lucky.
Thank you so much. And you know what, like as I said, so many things to celebrate. We got champagne. Mm-hmm. But listen, we are having a very sensual holiday party. So we can't have holiday party without some booze, right? So I thought I'm going to prepare for you one of my absolutely favorite cocktails. And I told you that we kind of have to come up with a name, and we really haven't even had a moment today, because we've been kind of getting ready and you know, getting ourselves all glammed up for our holiday party. But this is a very sensual drink, and I really, really hope that you can try this at home. It has lots of aphrodisiacs, and it has lots of holiday cheer. So I hope you're as excited as I am. So let's begin, shall we?
We shall.
So we can actually have a toast. All right, so we're gonna do it with champagne, okay? Mm-hmm. So sparkling wine is perfect. All right, so we got champagne glasses, because I think that make everything so wonderfully festive. And right here I got some pomegranate molasses. If you don't have pomegranate molasses, and they're so fragrant, and they're just gonna make your champagne look almost like Coke, but it's gonna be just absolutely delicious, and it's so rich. And of course, the reason why I like to use pomegranate molasses is because pomegranate molasses are loaded with antioxidants, and pomegranates in general, they're like a symbol of fertility.
Oh.
So it's really, really wonderful, and it's just probably one of the best known aphrodisiacs out there, because it gets your, you know, temperature going, it gets everything going, so it's really, really good for you. All right, so we got pomegranate reduction there.
So how much do you pour? Just,
you know, maybe a couple of tablespoons is probably gonna do it.
Mm-hmm.
All right, then I'm gonna add a pinch of cinnamon, because cinnamon is wonderful for your digestion. And I mean, it is just so wonderfully fragrant. And what a classic Christmas flavor and a fragrance, right? Because we think of apple pie, we think of, you know, different baked cookies with the cinnamon. It's really amazing.
It does smell like pie.
It does, right? Mm-hmm. So, and again, it's an aphrodisiac, and it's also wonderful for your digestion. So if you're having a little aperitifs just to get your guests going and prior to the meal, this is the drink to entertain with. To this, I'm gonna add a pinch of ginger. Ginger is wonderful if you're, you know, if there erectile dysfunction is a big problem. So if you have some problems in that area, No problem. Make sure that you include ginger into your diet and
also,
see how you feel.
It cancels out the booze, right? Because it's super healthy.
Oh, it's so healthy. You can have
That's
two
right.
glasses. Or five. I'm just going to ask you to scooch in a little bit, Anna, just for the purposes of framing. Thank you so much. And then, of course, we got to add my favorite aphrodisiac, right?
Chili peppers?
It's cayenne pepper. Yeah, but you can certainly use chili peppers. But cayenne is a little bit more finely ground, and it's so fragrant. And you can actually even just, you know, use a little bit of chili flakes in your maybe food processor just to wake them up a little bit, just to make them even more fragrant. So it's really, really fantastic. All right, and what chili pepper does is that, first of all, it just wakes up your taste palates. It just gets everything going. It mimics the way you feel when we're sexually aroused. It fastens your breath.
That's what it does.
Yes, ma'am.
I didn't know that.
Right. So already we have a nice little base for our Christmas drink.
And that looks so pretty.
It does. It does. And again, we're kind of using all the flavors that are so dominant in kind of traditional North American Christmas cooking, right? And kind of things that we're used to. So it was really important for me to kind of keep it that way. So I'm gonna ask you to open some champagne because I think we're ready to introduce some fun.
I used to bartend, so this is my skills are finally useful outside of that.
You know, other than the fact that she's absolutely gorgeous, and as I said, I want to celebrate her because she is my best friend. You know, I also wanted her on the show because she knows how to open champagne. I don't.
All right, well, I'm glad.
All right, hold on.
Okay, should I shake it up?
Shake it up, girl. Shake it up. Here we go. All right, I see some likes. I see some. Oh! Here we go. Look at that. That's just sensual activity right there.
So sensual.
All right,
okay.
So let's pour some of the cheers, some of the booze there.
Mm-hmm.
Fantastic. So we have champagne, if you're just tuning in. Sparkling wine.
Ooh,
look at that. I love that. Sparkling wine is going to do that as well.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So to this, you want to add a little bit more? I know Anna doesn't, you know, she loves her booze, okay? She's Eastern European, just like me. We enjoy our drinks, right?
We do.
So
abundance to spill over.
I love that. I love how you justify everything. This is what she does as well. I call her and I tell her that I did something wrong, and then she will say, "Oh, that's okay, honey. It's for the good of the world."
It certainly is.
So as you can see, it actually created a little bit of a little bit, almost like a balayage effect, right? So if you can see it, so that those pomegranate molasses are just at the bottom, almost kind of settling in, and it just looks beautiful. So as you're going to be sipping it, you're just going to be able to taste it as it's coming up, and it's going to be just divine. And then, of course, to go with the theme of pomegranates, I want to add some pomegranate seeds, almost like beautiful jewels. Just like that, floating around in our drink. What do you think? A little more?
I think a little more champagne.
A little more champagne? Okay, go for it.
Told you. Never too much.
Never too much. Okay, we're going to add a couple more things in there.
Okay.
Again, I want to keep it with Christmas theme, right? So we're going to add orange. I don't know about you, but I find that when I smell oranges, I always think of Christmas.
Mm.
I always think of New Year's. I always think of those holidays, right? So I'm just going to throw that in there. And last but not least, how about a little scent of pine, a little scent of forest, a little scent from your childhood when, you know, the trees were real. That's right, when the Christmas trees were real, right? When
I love
right?
the smell of Christmas trees.
And I mean, rosemary is that wonderful celebration of Christmas tree. Look at that. Just perfectly piney and so festive and just so comforting at the same time. So we're just gonna throw it in there.
This looks amazing. Look at the colors.
Look at that. All right.
So excited.
How is this?
Looks amazing.
As
oh
if
my
just
goodness.
Come into the frame just a little bit, just so
oh,
people
great, great.
See both of us. Okay.
Wow.
How is
this? Fantastic, girl.
And
you can perfect for Instagram if you do macro shot. It just looks amazing.
So true. And you can make this in the comfort of your home. It's actually very, very simple. Now be careful with chili pepper. it might just affect your lungs a little bit, it might kind of give you a shock, so you really have to enjoy it kind of slowly, not the way you like to, okay?
Mm-hmm. What?
Know, the whole thing, by the way. I've seen it. It's a true story. All right, so here's to holidays.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, happy holidays, whatever you celebrate. We would like to wish you all the wonderful things. But a few more things that we got to talk about, but let's try this.
Can I drink?
Oh, please. My goodness. You see, this is why we get along. So what do you think?
So good.
Can you taste those molasses there, just kind of infusing our sparkling wine or champagne?
Mm-hmm. And the effervescence brings all the spices up. So you feel the cinnamon and the ginger and everything else.
Can you tell that she's been hanging out with me quite a bit? I mean, she talks about effervescence and she talks about all the spices and aromas and flavors. Yeah, that's all my influence.
Mm.
Just saying.
Definitely.
So listen, I have to tell the world that you are an absolutely phenomenal entertainer. You throw incredible parties. You know, you are really, really great at that. You are master when it comes to bringing people together. You know, I've been to so many of your parties and they never fail to amaze me. We always have a good time. So I want to ask you, what do you think is the most important thing when it comes to throwing a sensual holiday party? While I'm drinking my
essential holiday party. Well, I don't know about sensual, but I think the most important part is to host your guests correctly, to give attention to each of your guests. And for me, a party isn't about just a party. It's more like a job, my job. You know, when you go with the kid is having fun. You're also having fun, but in a different way. Your job is to kind of serve the kid.
Mm-hmm.
So the same for me, when there are guests around, my job is to make sure that everyone is welcome, that I introduce my guests to each other, that I have a good mix of people. And the rest, of course, good food is important. Good food, good drinks, lighting, people love candles. I think humans are suckers for fire and light. So whatever you can bring it in, like Christmas lights or candles or glow sticks, something to kind of stimulate the eyesight. It also makes really good Instagram posts, which we all love.
Listen, we are just obsessed with Instagram, right?
We are.
It's great, and it's a great platform. And you're so right. It's so important to engage all of your senses. And don't hesitate to start cooking when your guests come in, right? Because that's going to welcome them, that scent of homemade meal. It is so important. Or try to prep before and then, maybe serve, maybe reheat it right before. But make sure that people can tell that you have been cooking, because it really makes people so happy, you have to admit.
Oh yeah, good food is so important. Just a bowl of chips and salsa is okay, but putting that energy into food, people really appreciate it. So it's not just about talking, it's about eating and drinking and enjoying and smelling and tasting and seeing, so and being seen.
Absolutely.
Right? Yeah.
And one thing that I want to ask you for your opinion is, I'm wondering, what do you think when people say that Christmas is just for the kids? Because I want to tell you what I think about it, but I want to hear your thoughts about it first.
My thoughts, Christmas is for everyone. Holidays are for everyone. There is a kid in all of us. We all enjoy things. And it's not, you don't have to give gifts to each other, but just spending that time with your family, with your friends. You have a few days off, you can have a cocktail party or just a get together over tea. So yeah,
what do you think?
So that actually really kind of bothers me a little bit when people say that Christmas is just for the kids, because I think that as we age, as we grow old, we have so many people who maybe lost their pets or lost their loved ones over the years, right? And they don't necessarily have that same community as some of us do, maybe who do have children. So I really think that it's a good excuse to bring everyone together. Christmas is for everyone, for your family, for your friends, for your neighbors. So, and I also think that we shouldn't put so much effort into making it all that fancy, or we kind of did, right? Because it's really easy. But if that's not necessarily your thing, you don't necessarily have to kind of put so much pressure on yourself and do that. Just bring everyone together. Don't worry about how many plates are broken in the end. And don't worry about the size of your home, because really, it's all about the atmosphere that you create. It's all about the people that you bring together and the way you make them feel welcome. So, you know, and shower them with love, shower them with attention. Make them feel that they're important. And really, only have the people that you truly love at your Christmas holiday get together, because I think it's really, really important. So I agree with you. I don't think that Christmas is just for the kids. Christmas is for everyone. Holidays are for everyone, and we should include everyone. So I think that our guests are getting here.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to thank you for years and years of friendship, of support. And I want to wish you this holiday season lots of amazing friendships. And, you know, maybe lots is not even the right word. Some amazing, deep,
quality,
sensual, quality friendships who bring you comfort, who bring you warmth, and who truly bring happiness to your home. So thank you very much for, you know, for allowing me to host this incredible cocktail party. We're gonna keep drinking, we're gonna keep enjoying ourselves. And to all of you, from our table to yours, I'm Emanuela Fernandez. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Thanks, love.
Thank you. I love you really good.
I love you too, honey.
Will you press the button?
I will.
Please. All right. It's a wrap. Now we can party.
Okay, where is the button? Oh, end.